camera just everyone. Let's dive into the best 2020 tech menu to dine for. I will not go into detail of each product. That will be on the next upcoming videos, coming up soon. I just need this gear for a film shoot. Let's start from the appetizers, then go into the main course.
Come on, seriously, you guys. The food is really expensive.
The first item on the menu is a HDMI cable, a regular HDMI cable to micro HDMI cable. This is for the A7 III.
Open up.
I needed a flexible HDMI cable, and this one is the one that I really needed. It is a flexible HDMI cable. It is decent quality, and this is by Came TV. I will link all the products in the description box down below. You can check them out. I will keep you guys updated on this HDMI cable, how well it's made. I don't know how high quality this micro HDMI cable is, but it'll definitely do the job.
Mesdames, Monsieur, bon appétit.
The second item on the menu is a 6,600 milliamp L-type battery. And this is by Neewer. This is for a light or a monitor. And I went with Neewer because I was really skeptical on other brands of L-type batteries, even with the mouse of 6,600 milliamp batteries. So I just went with the Neewer. It had good reviews. And this is a massive battery. This thing is huge. It's well built.
Voila. Bon appétit.
Next item on the menu. This is open two rubber rings. This is a replacement for tripods that have the rubber rings in between the legs. I'm going to try out these rubber rings if I can replace them on the TA6 Gazelle tripod. If it will work, I will comment down below if it worked or not. It is always good to have, just in case, rubber rings if you lose one from the TS6 Gazelle tripod. And that's why I got this. It does stretch, so it's not your hard rubber. Hopefully these rubber rings will fit the TS6 Gazelle tripod. Maybe it's gonna be even a better fit than the manufacturer rubber rings on the TS6 Gazelle, because it might be a tighter fit. Because the ones right now on the TS6 Gazelle, the rubber rings, they're kind of loose, not too loose. They kind of slip off from the tripod.
Voila. Bon appétit.
Next item on the menu. And this is Andy Cine A6 Plus version 2. There's a version 1, and this is the newly released version of the Andy Cine touchscreen monitor. I'll throw on the screen the difference between the version 1 and version 2, and you'll see the differences. Andy Cine did update all the issues with the version 1 of the A6 Plus monitor. I'll make a separate video about this monitor. Like I said, I need this gear for a film shoot, so that's why I'm going through quickly through all their products. And also, I can test out what I like about it, what I don't like about it. That's why I make these kind of videos, to unbox some gear, and then I go back and then I review in depth of each product. I was researching a lot about monitors, and the best affordable monitor is Andy Cine A6 Plus, especially for the version 2. They fixed all the issues from the version 1. Let's get into the box. Comes with a hood, and this is a Velcro hood, and this is made out of plastic, very flexible plastic. The monitor itself, and this is a 5.5 inch display. I'm impressed how well built it is. I thought there's gonna be flex into the plastic, but there isn't. It's absolutely a solid monitor. I'm amazed how Andy Cine made such a awesome, affordable monitor. It takes a L-type battery and a Canon battery. And there's no memory in here, so you have to have a SD card sticking out of this monitor. Hopefully this monitor will work with sunglasses. Hello? You got the wrong phone number. Wrong phone number. Continuing on with the unboxing. Get a microfiber cloth, paperwork, instructions. All the way in the bottom of the box, you get this is a 1 foot cable, regular HDMI to micro HDMI cable. I don't really like this one because of the stiffness of the cable, and it doesn't have that much flex to it, like the one that I got. And this is a 2 foot cable. This one is way too short. Comes with a mounting bracket and a bumper to protect the sides of the monitor, which is really awesome. Also, the Andy Cine is a 1080p display, not 4K. It reads out 4K.
And you, ma'am,
How's the food?
And now let's get into the main course of the meal. And this is the Ronin SC. I was debating between three gimbals, the Ronin SC, Mosa Aircross 2, and Weeble S. The Weeble S, I don't recommend to get that gimbal because of how cheap it is made. A lot of people complain about the plastic and how it makes noises and it's not that well built. Yes, that gimbal does have some advantages over other gimbals, but the quality is not there for the Weeble S. I was thinking about to get the Mosa Aircross 2. The Mosa Aircross 2, it was too big and you can't really travel with the Mosa Aircross 2. And after researching between those three gimbals, I just decided to get the Ronin SC. Especially where you mount a arm to the Ronin SC, you want a good quality material on a gimbal to mount on the sides of a gimbal. There has been thousands of unboxing of the Ronin SC, so let's make this unboxing very quick. And this is the case that comes with Ronin SC, this kind of a foam case. There's multiple items that come with the Ronin SC. Instruction manuals, some tools, USB Type-C cable, USB Type-C cable to micro USB, USB Type-C to USB Type-C, tripod stand, a riser, smartphone holder, the battery grip to power the gimbal, and the gimbal itself, the Ronin SC, and a plate. I'm going to set all this up. I will go into the whole setup in a different video. If you thought this video was helpful, share it. If you liked this video, click the like button, click the notification bell to be notified when there's a new video, and also subscribe. Be brave when choosing the right menu to dine for. Until next time. Hold up. Before you click on this video, if you're new to this channel, welcome. This channel, War Videographer, is about being a brave filmmaker, taking on the harsh terrains of this world, eyes open to film not the illusion of this world, but the realism. Thank you, everyone, for subscribing and sharing this channel. I truly appreciate it. Also, Warrior Videographer has hit 100 subscribers. You guys are awesome. Thank you. 2 years, 11 months ago, this channel, Warrior Videographer, was born. Warrior Videographer channel has 102 videos and more videos coming. From the beginning of this channel, it was tough to get the equipment to be easier for my vision because I am halfway blind or visually impaired. Finally, I got a monitor, so now it's easier to see a gimbal so that I don't have to worry about if the image is stable or not. So now it's gonna be 100% stable, so that eases the strain of my vision of the gear that I unboxed in this video. This is a new era for the Warrior Videographer channel. The footage is gonna be better and smoother. The quality, the best as it could get right now, which is 4K. I think 8K is way overkill. 4K is still really good, still sharp. Currently right now filming on a7 III. I still love the camera except the screen because I can't see with polarized sunglasses. With this new era that we're entering in with this Warrior Videographer channel, it is a lot easier for me now to film and there's less stress on my eyes as a visually impaired person. So I'm really excited for what's to come for this Warrior Videographer channel, and hopefully you are also excited for this Warrior Videographer channel, and I would truly appreciate it if you can share this channel. You will see me soon, audience. Until next time, Nachamdis.